Yes, I definitely agree with that. I was listening to a podcast recently with Mark Zuckerberg, and that was one of the things he was stressing very strongly was the importance of culture. What in your opinion, is the definition of culture? Sometimes it's sort of hard to like grasp, you know, an internal organization's culture. How do I affect it? What is it? How do I affect it? And why is it so important, especially with a small company, when you're just getting started, where somebody might not think culture is that important because they only have a couple of employees, but, you know, not thinking ahead for growth.
Yeah, so I mean, I look at culture, and I don't think there's one set definition, but I think it can be defined as a set of guiding principles upon which you govern yourself when engaging with clients, customers, consumers of your services, or the community at large. And so those guiding principles are typically influenced top down. I mean, it's kind of the way our capitalistic society is set up. The senior folks are looked to set culture. But I also believe that it's a bottom up and they meet in the middle, where the senior leader should have a vision and a mission that they're trying to communicate effectively. And the staff level all the way to middle management need to be encouraged that it's important to have a culture that embraces the mission and vision, but also in healthcare, the patients and their families. And so when you see organizations that have mottos and slogans and collateral that says the patient is our North Star, the patient is the most important factor or the most important stakeholder within our community. Well, if that was the case, then the Center for Medicaid and Medicare Services probably wouldn't have had regulations around patient satisfaction scores. So if that was really true, then organizations would have been structured to provide the patients with the best experience. That's cultural. So if your culture is transactional and it's not transformational, if your culture is task-oriented and not vision-oriented, if those things are in place and your culture is not at a place where it can actually embrace change readily, maybe over time, but not readily, and the speed of disruption within healthcare, not different from other industries, but I think the stakes within healthcare sometimes are higher because it's human beings and diseases and sick care and life and life or death in many situations. That speed of disruption requires a very flexible and viable culture that the leadership hopefully has set, but the staff level and middle management have nurtured. So like I said, no real set definition on culture, but you're right, it's hard to put your finger on it. But you can tell when you ask the frontline individuals within an organization, you know, what's the most important strategic imperative to the organization? And if they start to give things that are personal, like, you know, I wish I had better pay or more time off, it's only because they aren't connected to the vision of the organization. So that's a cultural thing. Or when you go into organizations and the frontline staff say, you know, we're here to care for everyone, no matter what ethnic origin, where they come from, where they live, income level, other socioeconomic status, we're here to care for everyone at any cost. That's culture. So I hear both, and it's unfortunate that I hear the prior, but when we do, we know that that's an opportunity for that organization to get help, to help nurture a different culture.
Mm-hmm. So for advice for the small entrepreneur who maybe has a handful of employees, or maybe the mid-sized employer who sort of lost focus on culture, what are some a couple of key takeaways, some tangible things that they can do to improve on their culture? Maybe they have a mission and values and vision on a piece of paper somewhere in the back office, but there's no real culture going on. How do they facilitate that? What are a couple of action steps they can take?
Yeah, good. So since we're in healthcare, I kind of use something that I've stolen from a number of really good thinkers, and that is, you know, a prescription before diagnosis is considered malpractice. So you before you kind of get everyone together and say, our culture is bad, and we need to do things differently. We need a better culture. But before you do that, kind of diagnose what's really going on.